Hey guys, Awaken Gaming back here again with another tutorial. So, you've just installed Kali Linux, but what do you do now? Well, that's what we're going to be talking about today. Here are my top 5 things to do after installing Kali Linux. As mentioned in the intro, we will be doing this in a top 5 style video. Let me know in the comments if you enjoy this style or you prefer a different style. And be sure to stick around for number 5, which is my favorite. Alright, let's go ahead and get into it. Number 1, update and upgrade. To start off this list, we will update and upgrade our new installation of Kali Linux. So to start that, you come open a terminal, type in sudo apt-get update, press enter, use your same password that you used to log in, and now this is working. As you can see, it's pulling down files, and once that's completed, to do the upgrade, you type sudo apt-get upgrade dash y. It should not ask you for your password this time. And now all those files that it pulled in, it is replacing the old files with. Once this is completed, you will have successfully updated and upgraded your system to the newest version. Number 2, install VirtualBox Guest Editions. So for number 2, we're going to install VirtualBox Guest Edition 11. This will enable us to use shared clipboards and drag and drop, among other things. So the command for this is sudo apt-get install VirtualBox. Dash guest dash x11. Once this is completed, you will have VirtualBox Guest Editions installed and configured. Number 3, enable shared clipboard and drag and drop. For number 3, we're going to enable shared clipboard and drag and drop. To accomplish this, we need to come back to our Oracle VM VirtualBox Manager interface. Click on the VM you want to enable this on, go to Settings, it's under General, Advanced, Shared Clipboard, we want this to be biradial, and drag and drop, also set this to biradial. Click OK, the settings will apply, and now the next time you launch your Kali Linux VirtualBox, you will be able to copy and paste things from your main computer into Kali Linux and vice versa, as well as drag and drop folders to and from your Kali Linux machine and your main desktop. Number 4, install Htop. So for number 4, we're going to be installing Htop, which will allow us to look at our resource management, such as how much CPU usage, how much RAM usage, swap usage, and things of that nature. So to install Htop, let's go into a terminal, type in sudo apt git install htop. Type your sudo password in. Once this has been finished installing, you will successfully have htop. To use htop, simply type in htop and it will bring up your htop interface. Number 5, take a snapshot. So finally we get to my favorite, which is taking a snapshot. With a snapshot, you are basically saving the state of the machine so that if ever in the future you have something break on you, something stop working, you can always revert back to the snapshot and it will be as if you never did all of those things that broke or messed up your VirtualBox. So to do this, we can click on these 3 dots, go to snapshot, take a snapshot, and then we can name it. Now, since we have done all the updates, upgrades, and new installations, I'm going to call it Fresh Updates with New Software. Press OK. And now at any point, we can go and restore to that point. If you guys enjoyed, please consider subscribing and hitting the notification icon so that way you are notified when future content is uploaded. Did you like the style of this content, the top 5 style? If you did, please leave that in the comments below. If you didn't, or you would like to see other types of styles being tried out by us, let us know your favorite in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll catch you again on the next one.